Ah, Morbius. The movie's so nice, it bombed twice. Morbius was not great. But you know what was great? Those smoke effects. So I'm gonna show you how to make them in the free version of DaVinci Resolve. So without further delay, it's Morbin time. All right, here I am inside of DaVinci Resolve. So I found this footage on pexels.com, this guy doing some parkour. Think that'll work well for this effect. So for this effect, like a lot of effects, you're gonna need to cut out your subject from your background. There are a lot of ways to do this, and I go more in detail on this video here, but for me, I just put this in Runway ML and got this green screen clip. So I'm gonna select all these, new Fusion clip, and go into Fusion. All right, so it merged together our media ends. So I'm gonna bring this to the screen, see which one it is. That's the footage, so I'm gonna hit F2 and rename it Footage. And then do the same for the green screen clip. And we're not actually gonna need the merge. So with the green screen clip, I'm going to add a delta key here, and just key that out like that. Now let's start adding the smoke. So I'm going to add a P emitter and a P renderer. Bring those over here. If you look at that in the viewer, I'm going to change the output mode and the P render to 2D. Then the P emitter, I'm going to go to the region and change the region to bitmap. Then we can just bring in our delta key here. Now it's hard to see the particles, so I'm going to right click, choose options, and then uncheck checker underlay. Now we can see them a little better. In the controls, I'm going to change the color to use color from region. Now it's using the colors from our guy. It's kind of hard to see, so in the style tab, I'm going to change the style to blob and then bring the size up all the way. So while we're tweaking the particle settings, using your footage as the bitmap is going to run really slow. So I'm just going to bring in a text, put some random text in, under the color, I can change the type to gradient, and just choose some random colors. We'll switch back to our footage at the end, but this will make things run a lot faster. So if we take a look at that, I'm gonna bring up the number all the way to 100. So first, let's add a P turbulence. Bring up the X strength, Y strength, and Z strength. And bring up the densities somewhere around maybe 20. Let's take a look at that. Now it adds this random movement. It looks kind of like smoke. What we can do is add another P turbulence and leave all the settings on this as default. That'll just add another layer of detail. Under the P emitter, we can change the lifespan to about 40 and bring up the variance a little bit. Now they're not staying too long. Then under the style tab, go under fade controls and fade them in, then out a bunch. Take a look at that. That's looking nice. Now at this point, we can bring back our footage in. So with this next step, your computer may hate me, but it's gonna look a lot better. I'm gonna go into the number and add a zero. It's gonna run a lot slower, but it looks a lot better. So next, let's add a blur. Bring it to about 5. We can change it later, but 5 seems to work well. Now let's make it look like smoke. So I'm gonna add an abstraction node. Bring that to the viewer. Bring the abstraction strength all the way down. Then bring the edge strength almost all the way down. You can see it's pinching it in, but it looks a little bit blobby. So let's add an erode dilate, change the filter to circle, and bring the amount down to about 0.003. Now it's looking better, but one thing we can do to add some variation is bring in a fast noise, bring that to the other viewer, and plug that into the mask of the erode dilate. Now we can bring up the detail, bring up the scale, change the type to discontinuous, and you can play with the contrast. So instead of eroding the whole thing, it's just doing in little selective patches to make it look even more smoky. And we can just bring up the seed rate just a little bit. Next, to bring out some more detail, let's add a sharpen. Now we can merge it over our footage. Take a look at that. Change the apply mode to lighten, and then add a CC right after the sharpen. Now we can play around with it to get it to pop. This is optional, but I'm gonna bring it to purple, bring more of that Morbius look, and bring up the gain just a little bit. One thing we can do to add some detail is add a displace, and then just bring the color corrector into that. So if we take a look at that, I'm going to change the type to X and Y, then just bring up the X strength a little bit, and do the same with the Y strength. Like with all my tutorials, this is just the jumping on point, so really tweak all these settings to get an effect you're happy with.
Be sure to subscribe, or Sony will make Morbius 2.